cut.
Okay, okay. So, okay, some inspiration. First high school race, 21:46. Still had.
Don't mention my name.
Still had a loop, but 21:46, all the way down to where I am now. Still had a loop too.
Hey, you still can't outkick me. You still can't outkick me. At least he doesn't.
Okay,
care.
Okay. 40.
Stop crying.
Okay, okay. Saturday night, 40.
What?
We're doing. Oh, it's turned off. Okay, no. Okay, we're doing a 40.
All right.
Fat. Okay. Kick.
Dude, you gotta put it out like this. You gotta like have it up there.
That. There you go. All right. 40.
Okay. We're doing a 40. Yeah. I don't know. To be determined.
Excited. I haven't been in there in about 10 years, and when I was here last, it was all the old wooden stands and everything, and I think the atmosphere is just the same. It's exciting, considering this Tracktown USA, rightly so. The history of the Mr. Bowerman, Nike projects, and of course Prefontaine. And most recently, this brand new stadium developed for the World Track and Field Championships to be held here next June 2022. And I'm sure it'll be the scene or the site of the 2024 Olympic trials again. Could be cool. Hopefully we have some guys that are going to be here for the Olympic trials this year and the Olympic trials in 2024.
I'm bummed I never got to see old Hayward, but This looks pretty sweet, so we'll show you guys around.
Put a lot of money into it, so
better be sweet.
Here we are. Here it is.
Take a picture of me standing. This is it. A new stadium.
Start off at a 30.
Okay, well, you start off.
I don't want you hawking me down. I'm trying to. Okay. Now we'll go punch them out.
Yeah, get down here. Sit down, put your spikes on. Jump inside.
So, I mean, it's pretty crazy because it feels like the stadium is like right on top of you. You know, you're in this bowl. It really feels like you're like ready to put on a show. And the old Hayward was kind of like open on both ends, and you had these old like grandstands, but they were kind of like set back and like went far up. This is like steep. So, it's pretty cool. I mean, it kind of like, well, like, I don't know, absorbs you into the atmosphere here, which I like the like throwback with, you know, the wooden beams, kind of like the retro like Oregon look, put in a modern design. It's tastefully done. Pretty cool.
The shower.
Whoa.
It's like, oh man, practice area.
That's sick. It's all like, the track material.
Wow. You can do a whole walk around the whole thing in spikes.
Yeah.
That's sick.
Oh, this is there's an indoor like throwing cage.
That looks like it's an indoor pole vault practice right there.
Yep.
Throwing cage.
Yeah, like, you got a vaulted organ now, man.
Vaulted organ.
Right. That's sweet.
Yo, my band's looking kind of sick.
Damn. Probably three. But I can't look him too goofy.
Yeah. Too short is gonna be a problem.
Yeah.
It's not long enough for a mullet yet, so unfortunately.
Okay, so he's got maybe hit the sides a little short. The top will wall, you know, like you got. Yeah. Yeah.
Take a seat, my friend. Alright. Okay. Pretty normal.
Mason's side gig, barber.
Where do you normally get your haircut?
Hair spot.
Oh, that's a pretty good one. I like the hair spot.
Wow, this is that's bad. Nasty. How'd that get through TSA is what I'm wondering.
My hair or the clippers?
Both.
Honestly, they didn't say anything about the clippers. They're scissors.
Yeah, I was thinking that. When we were on the plane, I was like, wait, Mason said he brought his kid. I was like, I wonder if he's got clippers.
A bottle of water, they get mad.
Yeah. Like, that water could be explosive.
Yeah.
Scissors.
But they let you bring scissors.
One, whatever.
It's looking fresh. Do we have gel or, like, wax?
I got some hair products.
Him.
The only good Let's Run post about me was someone said my hair looked nice.
Really?
I feel like that's like the highest compliment.
I know, it was. Like, I was like I'm riding that Let's Run compliment for the rest of my career.
Yeah. That one comment's got a lot of, it's got a lot of uphill work to do, you know. Take him on and rest on Michigan and stuff.
Yeah.
Can't.
Honestly.
No, I don't
think someone should really tell Ron how to make, like, run a Michigan. He clearly doesn't know what
to do. Yeah, exactly.
Did I tell you there's a...
I mean, Let's Run is like the melting pot of all knowledge for running. So if they're telling us we're doing it wrong, they got to be right.
Yeah, you're doing it really wrong with Let's Runs.
Yeah.
Like, I can't decide if it's old heads or like high schoolers or both. Like,
I feel like it's like...
It's a little bit of both. It's the melting pot.
Yeah.
It's the holy grail of running knowledge.
There was a...
This has got to be your new business. Like, you're the traveling barber. Yeah, exactly. For all the athletes.
Before me.
If you're watching this,
I take 10% of prize money.
So. that would actually be, you'd be raking it in. You gotta do it before a marathon.
I gotta go in the Diamond League circuit.
Yeah,
exactly.
Like win like $5,000.
But the deal is not 10% of prize money for that race. It's career earnings.
Career earnings, yeah. I think it's like an investment. You that's, know, no, you want a fast cut to run.
That's just 10. It's just
exactly.
10% more each time.
Yeah. Whoa, whoa, yeah. Sometimes we laugh and sometimes we cry, but I guess you know now. Where did these be at when they say they doing all this and all that? Tired of beefing you bums, you can't even pay me enough to react. Been waking up in the crib and sometimes I don't even know where I'm at. Please don't pay that songs in this party, I can't even listen to that. Anytime that I run into somebody, it must be a victory lap, ayy. Shawty come sit on my lap, ayy. They saying Drizzy just snap. This in between us is not like a store, this isn't a closable gap.
Look at me go. First you need to
get a little bit of wax in there and it'll be good to go. Yeah. We're getting ready, but the race before the race. Of course you're watching NASCAR. Very nice track club endorses NASCAR. No. If you want to be cool like us,
no.
Watch NASCAR. Go up. Go support Luke Warhurst Racing.
We endorse rally NASCAR racing.
That too. We endorse all forms of motorsports. No, we do not discriminate.
Just rally car racing.
This is making the cut for sure. This is a shameless plug. Look at it. It's like track and field. For everyone watching, this is like track and field.
So
but like this is more electric.
All
right, let's not even get into that argument.
It's like track and field.
Whose ticket is
any
this?
Type of racing.
But with traffic jams instead of running.
Yeah, they're going for it.
Poppy rot.
Show me your jersey.
It's in my bag, Ryan.
You got spikes? You got spikes?
I got spikes right there, of course. I got
in your
cleaned up for the race with Mason's fast cuts.
Okay, we want to play track.
8 second pickups. So,
I think you can do one or two on the grass, and then go in.
Yeah.
Be prepared to do two. 250, 60 yards straight away,
yeah,
when you're
just
in
there. Yeah, yeah.
Because I'll get you on the track. I don't know how long we'll keep you in there, 10 minutes maybe.
We have to follow our Oregon State laws.
On TV. Yeah, he's got it.
You guys
to decide.
Alright, see ya. 16 NC2A champion of the University of Michigan, a lifetime best at age 21-57, Mason Ferlic. Mason. Keter, Ferlic, Brooke Anderson and Deanna Price fouled their last two attempts. So in the hammer throw, Brooke Anderson the winner at 77.99 meters. You can see it on the scoreboard now. Deanna Price is second. Into the stretch. Up back to get a monster PR here. Ferlic's making a move. Lifetime best. Ferlic is last C8, 1849 in second, and Hillary Moore, 820. Remember, run indoors for a U.S. runner at 1305.60. Is Jordy Beamish. The 2018 NCAA.
Nice job, guys. Eyes up. There we go. You're good. You're good. Close it in.
Get one later.
Perfect hop. 158 hop. Pick up a guy left. Guy.
It's a hell of a kick.
And Hobbs Kessler coming across the line. Hobbs Kessler.
Hell yes.
3:33.54 for Hobart. Really impressive. 56.06 last lap for Hobbs Kessler. He had the fastest last lap of anybody.
You know, all in all, I think it was a good race. Obviously, PR, so that's huge. 8:18, Olympic standard. Two big boxes to check. I mean, Hayward's been good to me, so like I came out here ready to race. I'm actually surprised we ran that fast because I was just chilling in the middle of the race. I wasn't even thinking about time. You're just kind of like trying to practice good water pits, good hurdles, and so to run 8:18 without even feel like I'm pressing it was good. Obviously, missed the win there. That was a little tactical error. Isaac, great race, just got to jump on us with like a lap to go, and I didn't really expect him to open up that quick of a lead, and so just, you know, we couldn't close him down. So prop to him, but not losing next time out.
First race in the tights at Hayward?
First time in Hayward, yeah. First time in the Tracksmith kit out here, so yes. Last PR, 2016, was from here. 5 years later, now set the new PR, 818 out here.
It's only up from here.
Only up, yeah.
You got 60 seconds.
Yeah, I mean, I didn't even think we were
on the clock.
The weather isn't conducive, doesn't make a difference. Weather's weather. We came out here for Mason to run between 818 and 822, get the standard. He wanted to win. He beats his competition. Another surprise in there, but that's okay. He'll be ready to run 810, 812.
Yeah, I feel like I beat accelerating up.
And he led most of it, and it could have been better. But the weather, and it, but then in Hobbs was 14 people in the race. And,
did you get fifth?
He was sixth, I believe. But he ran 56
crazy last quarter.
And he ran 56 point last quarter. He passed six or seven people in the past 300, which is extremely impressive. So into a headwind, we're good. We're ready to go home for 6 weeks of training, and then we're back here again. Bye.
All right, we're really psyched right now.
There's a lot of energy in this.
Everyone is psyched.
There's a lot of mouth going.
We're going to run a few hills and kind of cool down. I'm jumping in. I'm psyched. I'm psyched. So
I'm good. I'm going.
We'll show you guys.
Hill.
Dad, you get the video. You get the video.
I'm not doing video.
No, you're getting video.
I beat him every time, and the last time going away, Mason was on me. He's right on the ground. Cut it out. And I flipped off Hobbs just way back. I'm getting for better. No. He's like,
he may have beaten Mason on the last
one. I beat him on all three.
I walked up here.
Yeah.
I beat him on the last one.
King of the hills. Yeah.
Woo! We gotta get
my ass hurts, so I'm done.
This is so much.
Got him.
Lightning. Don't be calling the storm.